I'm Lowell Gentry. I'm a research agronomist. I'm looking for ways of keeping nitrate out of our tiles, trying to tie it up and keep it in the field so they can be used by the crop. I'm going to talk about a very large experiment that was conducted in Douglas County. It was conducted on farm. It's a large replicated tile drainage study funded by the Nutrient Research and Education Council. And it's taken many folks, many researchers, students, and undergraduate help to pull this experiment off. We started it in 2015 and ended it in 2020, and recently published a paper on the first 4 years of our results. I'm going to start with this picture of one of our plots that is at this Douglas County farm. This photograph shows the importance of tile drainage. This is after a 2-inch rain event in May of 2016, and you can see that without tiles, we'd be waterlogged for a very long time in this area, and we have zero rise, one treatment. But the experiment is about splitting nitrogen application, not putting it all on at once. The idea was that if we could split apply or spoon feed the crop, we would have a more efficient use of the fertilizer and we'd find less of it in the tile. Also, we have the timing of N application as a treatment. So we have two adjacent fields where there's corn and soybean grown simultaneously. With six treatments and three replicates and both phases of the corn-soy rotation, we needed 36 monitored tile lines. So we have 36 plots. Each plot has a 5-inch lateral right down the middle of it. So by definition, the plot is 50 feet on either side of the lateral. Here's a map of the tile lines in the field. You can see that it's a corn-soy rotation and the corn and soybean is just swapping fields each year. You can see that there are three red blocks and three blue blocks. Within each block, we randomized the six treatments in this fashion, so it's a randomized complete block design. The six nitrogen treatments are the full rate of anhydrous ammonia in the fall with nitropyrin, a nitrification inhibitor. Another treatment is a three-way split where we put 50% of the nitrogen on in the fall with an inhibitor, and then 25% as UAN at planting and 25% as UAN as an early side dress. Our third treatment is a full rate of applied ammonium in the early spring. That's without an inhibitor. The fourth treatment is a reduced rate. It's 75% of the full rate, and that's an early spring application. Then our treatments 5 and 6 are the same nitrogen treatment, which is a 50-50 split, where we put half the nitrogen on as ammonium early in the spring without an inhibitor, and then the other 50% as UAN, or as an early side dress. And the sixth treatment is the same nitrogen treatment as that, but we add a cover crop. And we chose oat and radish after soybean and ahead of corn so that we didn't have any interference with the corn crop. We wanted it to winter kill. And then we tried cereal rye after corn ahead of soybean. The experiment was conducted under strip till for corn and no-till for soybean. And the full N rate was 160 pounds of N per acre for the 2016, 17, and 18 seasons. And then we did have some N deficiency at that lower N rate, so we went to 180 pounds per acre of nitrogen fertilizer in 2019. We have 36 tile monitoring stations. There's an agri-drain structure that intercepts the tile before it enters into a main tile and discharges to a creek. We have a V-notched weir plate in the agri-drain structure and a pressure transducer to measure the height of the water. We know the relationship between the height of the water in the V and the flow rate. So that's how we determine tile flow rate. We have an automatic water sampler out there so that we don't have to stay out there all night long. We can get samples anytime. They sample every 8 hours and we pick and choose what we need to characterize each event. And our nutrient analysis is nitrate, ammonium, phosphorus, and potassium. But today I'm only going to talk about nitrate. Within the agri-drain structure, you can see a V-notched weir. And this is what a typical agri-drain structure looks like during tile flow. With the corn yield over those 4 years, you can see that the split end treatments did tend to increase yield, however slightly. It wasn't statistically significant increase. And the only significant result we have is a decrease in corn yield with the 75% rate. Now we can look at the average soybean yield for those same years, and the end treatment to corn did not affect soybean yield. We didn't expect it to. The three-way split happens to be higher, but we have no real reason for that. The main thing here is that the cover crop did not interfere with soybean yield at all, and so we see no statistical difference. Good yields, but no difference across the six corn nitrogen treatments. Now we're going to look at a graph that shows the individual water samples that we collected. This is the tile nitrate concentrations in those samples. And here I'm actually showing the setup year where we only have spring nitrogen on for the corn and of course no nitrogen on soybean. And that shows our natural variability out there. So in late 2015, we imparted our nitrogen treatment. We put the 100% fall N on, also the 50% fall N on. And then we had oat and radish planted as well as cereal rye. And what you can see here is the effect of the fall nitrogen. Clearly increased tile nitrate concentrations above the other four treatments. You can see the separation between the treatments that had the fall N on versus the others that have spring N on. So in this graph, I'm showing the tile nitrate load, fall nitrogen versus spring nitrogen, but I also added the three-way split that received half of the nitrogen in the fall. I've also added a fifth year of data because, as I said earlier, we started at 160 pounds of nitrogen per acre as our fertilizer rate. And in 2019, we increased it to 180 pounds of nitrogen per acre because we saw N deficiency in 2018. And I didn't want folks to think that the increase in tile nitrate load in 2019 was just because we increased the fertilizer rate by 20 pounds. I don't believe that's the case. In 2019, we had a very wet spring and we planted late, and then we had some very large rain events in June and July that pushed out lots of nitrate through the soil and into tile lines for any of our treatments. But it was particularly bad for fall N that year. So just to show that the 180 pounds of nitrogen per acre was not responsible for that large amount of loss in 2019, we did keep some of the treatments going in 2020, and so I could add 2020 to this graph to show you that nitrate loss seemed very reasonable in 2020, even at the higher rate. But what we do see here is that fall N loss or fall N application leads to greater tile nitrate loss than does any of the spring N treatment. And the three-way split that got half of the nitrogen in the fall is always intermediate. So reducing from 100% of the fertilizer in the fall to 50% does help reduce tile nitrate load. However, it wasn't significant. It was not a significant reduction in our hands with our three replicated study. Fall and application overall increased tile nitrate loss by 12 pounds per acre. It elevated tile nitrate loss by 35% during the corn phase of the corn-soybean rotation. So 12 pounds per acre is only about 7 or 8% of the fertilizer. But that same amount is a substantial contribution to the nitrate load in the tile. On this slide, you can see that the cover crop effect, which was cereal rye, had a very dramatic reduction in tile nitrate, and that is the tile nitrate going down to about 2 part per million, starting closer to 7 part per million. We also realized after a couple of years of trying oat and radish that the oat and radish failed to establish enough biomass to affect tile nitrate. So we concentrated on cereal rye for the rest of the experiment. That reduction in tile nitrate came from a cereal rye cover crop that accumulated 1.1 tons of above ground biomass per acre, and it had accumulated 26 pounds of nitrogen per acre in its biomass. And that's enough nitrogen to have reduced the tile nitrate load by 9 pounds per acre. So that 9 pound per acre reduction is equal to about a 43% reduction in tile nitrate loss. This graph shows all of the tile nitrate data from the 4 years, from 2016 through 2019, of all 6 treatments in both corn and soybean. And so the top graph would be soy, corn, soy, corn, and the bottom graph would be corn, soy, corn, soy. This is the 4-year cumulative tile nitrate load graph. This shows the cumulative load every day over those 4 years. And where the lines are flat or horizontal, that's when tile flow has stopped. There's no tile flow, so there's no increase in load. And all the squiggly increases are rain events that are pushing more nitrate into the tile. And the treatments separated much as we had expected, that the full rate of nitrogen in the fall lost the most, and the 50-50 split in application with a cover crop lost the least. And these are the total loads, so you can divide those by 4, and 100% of the nitrogen in the fall would be about 29 pounds per acre loss, and the 50-50 with cover about 16 pounds per acre loss. But you can see that the splits do lose less nitrate than their companion treatment. That's 100% in the fall or 100% in the spring. Those are the full rate compared to the splits, and although not significantly different, we at least see nitrate going in the right direction with these splits. One thing I want to point out that I find very interesting is that the 50-50 split, which is the full rate of nitrogen, lost the same amount of nitrogen to the tiles as did the reduced rate treatment, the 75% in the spring. Here we are reducing the rate, and yet we didn't really reduce tile nitrate loss. But if you remember, we did lose corn yield due to that. This is the title of the paper that we just published. Split fertilizer nitrogen application with a cereal rye cover crop reduces tile nitrate loads in a corn and soybean rotation. You can look that up if you'd like the full story. But here is the most important table from that paper. And what I'm showing here is the 6 nitrogen treatments And I'm showing the annual flow-weighted mean concentration of nitrate in part per million for both the corn phase and the soybean phase, along with the annual loads. And you can see that both the flow-weighted mean nitrate concentration and loads are quite a bit higher during the corn phase versus the soybean phase. And there's no real surprise there. In fact, 64% of the tile nitrate occurred during the corn phase, with 36 coming from the soybean phase. Some overall results are splitting fertilizer and application did not significantly increase corn yields or lower tile nitrate. However, it was helping in the right direction in both cases. It slightly raised yield and it slightly lowered tile nitrate. So our hypothesis was somewhat borne out, but we just couldn't get the statistical difference with the power of three replicates. Now, tile nitrate was significantly greater with fall applied N than with spring applied N. And our final result is that the spring application of only 75% of the recommended fertilizer N rate significantly decreased corn yields by 8%, but did not significantly reduce tile nitrate compared to the full rate of fertilizer N applied in the spring. In conclusion, our results show that if we move our fall fertilizer application to the spring and we grow cereal rye every other year in front of soybean, not even trying to have a cover crop in front of corn, just every other year in front of soybean, we can reduce the tile nitrate load by about 45%, which is the goal stated in the Illinois Nutrient Loss Reduction Strategy.